ऑल राइट ऑल राइट दिस इज द एंड टू एंड फ्लो ऑफ द बीआई टेक्नोलॉजी. लेट मी गिव यू अ वेरी प्लेन एग्जाम्पल दैट लेट सपोज यू आर वर्किंग फॉर द डिफरेंट फॉर वॉलमार्ट कंपनीज. वन वॉलमार्ट कंपनी इज जस्ट मेंटेनिंग देयर डेटा इन टू एन एक्सेल शीट एंड दी अदर वॉलमार्ट कंपनी दे आर मेंटेनिंग देयर डेटा फ्रॉम दी ऑन दी TXT फाइल. ओके एंड दी अदर वॉलमार्ट कंपनी दे आर मेंटेनिंग देयर डेटा इन टू दी ओरेकल एंड दी अदर वॉलमार्ट कंपनी दे आर मेंटेनिंग देयर डेटा इन टू दी XML राइट. सो नाउ वॉट इज हैपनिंग इज दैट ऑल द डेटा हैज़ बीन एक्यूमुलेटेड विद द ETL टूल. ओके इन द इन्फॉर्मेटिका ETL टूल all the data has been accumulated. Now that data goes to the data warehousing for the reporting purpose, and then once the data has been loaded, then only Tableau comes into the picture for the analysis purpose, for the reporting purpose, and for the data mining purpose. Okay, now from here onwards Tableau comes into the picture. Once your data is ready for the reporting purpose, once your data is ready for the reporting purpose, okay, then only you can do your analysis of the data, then only you can do reporting of your data, and then only the data mining will be done with the help of Tableau only, right? Now let me compare, or you must have a question that we already have an Excel available with us for the data visualization, then why to use Tableau when you already have a feature in your Excel file that you can create your own data visualization, then why to use Tableau first of all? So in Excel file you have to do a lot of hard work. If you want to create your chart or if you want to create a dashboard, then it's a nightmare for you as far as Excel is concerned, okay? But if the similar kind of chart or graph if you have to create in your Tableau, it will be of the matter of less than 30 seconds. In 30 seconds we will be creating a data visualization, okay, in front of you all only. So first of all try to understand that how Tableau recognizes your data. Tableau recognizes your data in the form of dimensions and measures, okay? How Tableau recognizes your data? Tableau recognizes your data in the form of dimensions and measures. Now what is a dimension and what is a measure? All right, as far as your dimension is concerned, all your categorical data, which is your city, like which is your customer name, customer ID, okay, these are dimensions. All your date column, like your order date, shipping date, these are dimensions. All your geographical column, like state, city, countries, these are dimensions. Now what is a measure then? A measure is nothing but a numerical value on which you perform some mathematical calculations, okay? So just for your understanding, what is a dimension and what is a measure? Okay, let's suppose if I say 12 million, there is no meaning of that 12 million. 12 million means it's a measure, but there is no meaning of that. But if I say the sales for India is 12 million, then India is a dimension and that 12 million is a sales. All right, now if I say the sales for Rajasthan is 12 lakh rupees, so 12 lakh is a measure and Rajasthan is a dimension. All right, okay, if I say Rahul has done a sales for 12 lakh rupees, so Rahul is a dimension because it's a name and 12 lakh is a measure. Alright, I hope the difference between the dimension and the measure is quite clear to you. And this is one of the asked question in any interview, that what is the difference between a dimension and the measure. Alright, so according to the definition, what is the definition of a measure? The field which are constant, which never changes, they kept into the dimension. And the field which keeps on changing, okay, these are measures. Alright. Now what we'll do is we'll create a data visualization into the Excel sheet itself, and then we can see how we can create the data visualization into the Excel file, and then later on we can see how we can create the data visualization into the Tableau itself, right? Now let me open that particular source file. Okay, we have a source file called Global Superstore 2016. this is the data we have. Let me zoom in so that you can see that Excel data quite clearly. Alright, so this is the Excel data we have with us. Now by seeing this data, what you can understand, this data seems to be with an e-commerce website where some orders have been placed, right? So this is the order ID, this is the order date, this is the shipping date, this is the shipping mode, this is the customer ID. So these all are looks like a dimension, okay? And these are the measures. This is your sales, this is your quantity, this is your discount, this is your profit. These are measures and these other things are dimensions. Alright, so what we have to do, we just have to create a data visualization, alright, with this data, so that we can understand what was the sales done for the different category and subcategory. I can show you one more thing with this data, or let me tell you very important thing before creating my data visualization, that before creating your data visualization, your source data must be clear, which kind of data you are using. Okay, once your source data is quite clear, then only you will be able to create your data visualization. So here, this is the source data for the some e-commerce website, right? And what are the important column we have with us? Okay, this is the important column, this is the category, and this is the subcategory. What is that category and subcategory? Technology, we have three categories. Okay, technology is the category, furniture is the category, and office supplies is also one of the category. And what is the subcategory with us? We have in the technology, we have different subcategories. In furniture also, we have different subcategories. And in the office supplies also, we have different subcategories. Now, what is our purpose? The purpose is to create a data visualization for this category and subcategories. And we want to see how much sales have been done with this category and subcategory, so that we can give that data visualization to the business people, to the management people, right? That is what they want. So to create a data visualization into the Excel sheet, let me press Ctrl A, okay, and let me click on to this insert. And first of all, I need to create a pivot table. Okay, why I need to create a pivot table? See, this blank pivot table has been created. First of all, let me zoom in. Why I need to create a pivot table? I need to create a pivot table because first of all, I need to aggregate the data. I need to summarize the data. Once my data is aggregated, once my data is summarized, then only I will be able to create a data visualization. Now, which are the column which I want into my pivot table? I want category. So let me take this category into rows. Let me take subcategory also, and let me take into rows, and let me take sales. Let me take sales, right? Okay, so let me take sales and let me put it into values. All right. See, this pivot table has been generated. This pivot table has been generated. So just let me give it a border so that we can see it quite clearly. Now, what is the outcome from this pivot table? This is the sales for furniture. This is the sales for office supplies. And this is the sales for technology, right? And this is their respective sales for this subcategory. And this is the grand total, right? This is how you can create your pivot table. Now I want to create a data visualization, a bar chart. For that, just select this particular pivot table, go to the insert tab and click onto this 3D chart. And see, this particular bar chart has been created. Now, if I hover my mouse cursor onto a particular category, then it is showing me a tooltip. In that particular tooltip, I can see this is the sales for the furniture, or this is the sales for the bookcases. Okay, business is not worried about these bars because these are quite heavy. These are quite long, but they will be quite worried about this particular bar because these are really small. Okay, and the value, the sales for this particular label is 73,350 only, which is quite less. And what is the sales for this one? The sales for this particular bookcase is 14 lakh. This is quite heavy. So business will be really happy with this particular bar, but they will not be happy with this particular small bar. So they need to deploy a marketing people over there. They need to spend some money over the marketing so that they can improve the sales from here. Let's suppose my requirement is that I only want to see data related to furniture only. So let me check furniture only and see, I will only be able to see data related to furniture and with the respective subcategory, that is bookcase, chair, furnishing and tables. Okay, and from here you can see we have a minimum sales for the furnishing, that is only 3,85,000. And what is the maximum sale? We have maximum sales for chair, that is 15 lakh, which is quite heavy. Alright, so in that way you can create your data visualization in the Excel sheet. Alright, but don't you think that it's a very tedious way? It's a very tedious way. I'm just giving you the example of a simple bar chart, right? So this is quite easy to make, but still you have to create the pivot table. But let's suppose if I tell you, or the business people will tell you, or your manager will tell you that we need to create a dashboard, then it's a nightmare for you in the Excel sheet. It will take a lot of time and a lot of effort, but that can be done in Tableau in just minutes of matters, right? And today we'll be learning that how we can create our data visualization with the help of the Tableau. All right Alright, so let me open my Tableau software. This is the first user interface of Tableau, and let me connect to the Excel file itself, that same Excel file, that is Global Superstore 2016, right? So this is the Excel file which we have to connect to the Tableau, Global Superstore 2016. Let me open it. Now I have connected with my Excel sheet. Alright, now if you can observe in this Excel sheet, we have three tabs: orders tab, returns tab and people's tab. Alright, now I just only work on to the one sheet, that is orders tab, right? So what I can do is, in the orders tab I have all the three tabs with me, that is orders tab, people's tab and returns tab. So what I can do is, I can just drag and drop this orders tab and put it into this work area and see all the data which I had into my Excel sheet, that all the data I have with me into my Tableau software itself. Alright. So what I can do is, I can go to the sheet 1 and I can create my data visualization. Alright, so how do I do that? Let me just give you an overview with this Tableau user interface. Okay, let me repeat that what I did. I just connected myself with the Excel sheet, that is Global Superstore 2016, and what I did is, I just drag and drop this orders tab into the work area, and all the data which was there into my Excel sheet, now that all the data I have with me into the Tableau itself. Now if I want to create a data visualization, for that I need to go to the sheet 1. Okay, this is the data we have with us. Now let me just give you an user interface of this. This is the column shelf. Let me zoom in a bit so that you can see it quite clearly. This is the column shelf and this is the row shelf. This is the column shelf and this is the row shelf, right? What is that column shelf and row shelf? And first of all, I just told you that Tableau will recognize your data into the dimensions and measures. So these are the dimensions which has been created by Tableau, which has been segregated by Tableau. Okay, these all are the dimensions: your category, your city, your country, your customer ID, customer name, market, order date, everything. And these are the measures, these are the numbers on which you will be performing some mathematical calculation. So Tableau is a way smarter tool it will segregate your data automatically into dimensions and measures. All right, this is first thing. Now this is the column shelf and this is the row shelf where you just have to drag and drop your data. All right, and this is the filter shelf. This is also one of the most important shelf where you will be dragging and dropping your column. Okay, and this is the marks card. Okay, we will be learning what is that marks card. In the marks card you have couple of options available. Okay, we have colors. If you want to colorize your chart, you can use this option called color. Okay, and if you want to use this size option, you can use this size option to improve, to increase and decrease the size of your chart. If you want some label, you can use this label option. All right, one more important options which I wanted to give you. Okay, this is the sorting button. If you want to sort your data into descending order, you can sort your data from the on the descending order from this particular button. All right, and if you want to sort your data, you can sort your data from this button into the ascending order. Okay, and this is the T button. T button means the label button, if you want some label onto your chart itself. So let's create a data visualization, the similar visualization which we have created into our Excel sheet. So how I can do that? Just let me take this category and put it into column shelf. Okay, this is known as pill. What I did, let me repeat that point. This is the category, this is the field. So let me take that and put it into column shelf. Okay, and this is become a pill. This is known as pill. So if I use word that pill, don't get confused. All right, and if I take this subcategory, I can put it into the column shelf itself one more time. All right, and let me take that sales and put it into row shelf. See, your data visualization has been created in less than 30 seconds. You don't have to create any pivot table, you don't have to create or you don't have to put so much effort. Just drag and drop your dimensions and measures into the row shelf and column shelf and your data visualization will be created. I just now told you that if you want to sort your data, use these buttons. Which buttons? These two buttons. Okay, if I want to sort my data. Now let me click over here. And your data will be sorted. And let me click over here. Your data will be sorted into the ascending order. And in that way, it will be sorted into the descending order. Now I want the values over the bar itself. Now what I can do is I can take this sales. See, this is coming as sum of sales. This is not coming only just as sales. It is already aggregating your data. You don't have to create a pivot table. Take that sales. It is coming as sum of sales and put it into label. Okay, let me repeat that point. How you can do that? Take this sum of sales and put it into label. This is the label box. Okay, and there you can see all the data, all the measures are available. All right, in your bar chart itself. So in that way you can analyze your data. This is the highest generating revenue, and if you hover your mouse cursor onto this particular bar, you can see this is belongs to furniture category. Okay, and the subcategory is chairs. And what is the sales? The sales is 15 lakh and 1,000. All right, and what is the minimum sales? This is the minimum sales for the office supplies category. That is your 73 lakh and 350 rupees. Sorry, 73,000 and 350 rupees. This is very much minimum. All right, now what else we can do with this particular bar chart? We can explore a lot of options. Okay, so if you want to format this particular chart, how do you format that particular chart? First of all, if you want to format this particular chart, how do you format this particular chart? It's very easy and very simple in Tableau. You can just right click over here and click on format button. Okay, let me repeat that point. If you want to format your chart, right click over here and click on to this format button, format option. This particular window will be coming up. This is the window. Now if I want to increase or decrease the font size, I can increase the font size. Let me take it as 12, let me make it as bold, and let me make it as black. All right, So this is the formatting which has been done, and I can see my data quite easily and very clearly. And if you want to close this window, you can close this window from here. Close this particular window. Now someone can ask me that I do not want my this particular label as vertical, I want it as a horizontal. Then yes, you can do that. Go to this label box, here an option available called alignment. Okay, so slowly I will be giving you one or more options so that you can memorize it or you can write it, and later on you can do practice upon it. If I want to do an alignment in the horizontal, in the label box I have an option called alignment. Click over here and just click on to this particular button. Alright, and see that particular number is aligned in the horizontal. Alright, now someone can ask me why I don't see data for this particular bar. If I hover my mouse cursor, I can see that sales, that is 7,49,000 for the accessories. But I cannot see that data as a label. If you cannot see that data as a label, then what you can do is you can just right click over here, click on mark label, and you can click on to this always show, right? What I can do, right click over here, click on mark label and click on always show. You can see that data is available over here, right? So don't get confused if you cannot see the data as a label. You have to check this option, right click, mark label and always show. All right, now let's play with some colors. Okay, if I want to play with some colors, then how do I play with some colors? What you can do is, what is the best practice to play with color? Let me take this category, this particular field, and put it into color box. All right, and I can see that my different fields, my different categories have been colored with some different colors, right? This is the furniture has been colored with a blue color. This office supplies has been colored with an orange color, and this technology has been represented with a red color, and a color legend has already been created. This is known as color legend, which is indicating you which category belongs to which color. All right. Now, if you only want to highlight the furniture color, then if you only want to highlight the furniture data into this particular chart, then what you can do is you can just check this furniture. And this furniture will be highlighted only, and the other options will be grayed out, the other categories will be grayed out. If I only want to see data related to office supplies, then let me click on to this office supplies, and I can see that only this office supplies will be highlighted, this data, this bar chart will be highlighted, and the other options will be grayed out. If I only check this technology, I can see that only technology will be highlighted and the other data will be grayed out. Now someone can ask me, in this particular graph only, in this particular chart only, if I only want to see data related to furniture, then how do I filter that? Okay, if you check this furniture, in this particular tooltip, you have an option called keep only. Okay, you have an option called keep only. If you check this option keep only, you will be only see data related to furniture only. Alright, you will only be see data related to furniture only. Let me press a Ctrl Z. Ctrl Z is to for undo, so that you can go to the previous state. Alright. Now, what else we can do with this particular thing? As far as the colors are concerned, let's suppose I don't like this color. I'm not liking this color. Then how do I edit the colors? Let me go to this color box. Let me edit the color. And from here, I can edit my color. Let's suppose for furniture, I want to align this pink color. Okay. First of all, then click on apply and click on OK. How did I edit my color? Just go to this color box, click on to this edit color option, and there you can just check your own choice of colors from this particular drop down list. You have variety of colors available. All right. So this is how you can play with the colors. Now, this is not a good practice, because being a data scientist, what is your primary job? Your primary job is to give the maximum information to the user. But in that way, I'm not giving any information. So what I can do is, the moment you drag and drop this category into the color box, this pill, this color category pill has been created. if I want to remove this color, then let me just drag and drop this category pill from here and see that color has gone. Let me press Ctrl Z and let me show you one more time. Okay, what I can do is, if I want to remove this coloring option, or if I remove this coloring, then a color category, this pill has been generated. What I need to do is, I can just drag and drop and that color has gone, right? Now what I can do is, I can take this subcategory and put it into color box. Each and every subcategory will be represented with a color, but that is also not giving me some information. I am not getting any information. So let me remove this subcategory also. Now what is the best practice? The best practice is, instead of this dimension, let me put measures into the color. Alright. So what I can do is, I can take this sales and let me put it into colors. It is giving me some information. Which information? The more the color the dark is, the more the sales is, and the more the color the light is, the less the sales is, right? Okay, so this is how you can play with your colors. Alright, now what else we'll try to learn today? If you want to just remove this label, you can right click over here and you can remove this label. Alright, now someone can tell me that we don't like these numbers. Okay, we want the percentage values. We want to convert that number into the percentage values. How do I do that? Yes, I can convert these numbers into the percentage values also. Let me show you with some more sheet. I'm into my sheet 1. Okay, if I want to give it a name to that sheet, let me rename that sheet. Right click over here and you can rename your sheet as well. Let me take it as a name as sales. Alright, now let me go to one more sheet. If you want to go to one more sheet, just click onto this particular button. Okay, this one. Let me click onto this button. A new plain sheet has been created, right? I'll be answering your couple of questions one by one once I'll finish that particular example. Don't worry about that. Alright, this is the first sheet which has been created. Now I have to create one more sheet. Alright, so here we will be creating a pie chart. Alright, so let me create a pie chart. How do I create a pie chart? So to create a pie chart, what I can do is, I can just double click onto this subcategory. Alright, and I can just double click onto the sales. Okay, and let me sort it. Someone was asking me how we can sort. So here is the button to sort it in the descending or ascending order. Let me click over here and your data will be sorted into the descending order, right? Now if you can observe, or your observation skills are really good, you have a button over here called show me button. In this show me button, you have variety of charts available. In this particular show me button, you have variety of charts available. Whatever chart you want to create, you can create your chart according to your own choice, according to your own preferences, right? So I want to create a pie chart. So let me click on to this pie chart. And here, if you can read, to create any kind of chart, if I hover my mouse cursor onto a pie chart, the minimum requirement to create a pie chart has been written over here. One or more dimension and one or two measures. Okay, so we have one or more dimensions and we have one or more measures. So let me click onto this pie chart. And if you can see, a pie chart has been created. Okay, a pie chart has been created. Now let me resize this pie chart so that you can view it very clearly. In this particular drop down list, you have an option for the multiple visibility. Okay, let me take his entire view. So a bigger pie chart is there. What I did, let me repeat that point. Just go to here. In this drop down list, you have an option called entire view, right? So you can click onto this entire view and it will take all the views. Now if I hover my mouse cursor onto any area, it will be giving me the sales for that particular subcategory. The sales for appliances is this. what about this? The sales for copier is this, the sales for chair is this, but this particular pie chart is not much informative. I have to make it more informative. How can I make that? So what I can do is I can take this subcategory and let me put it into label pill. I have a name for the respective subcategories, and let me take that sales also and let me put it into label itself. I have the numbers with me also. All right. Now my management can tell me, we don't like these numbers. We want the percentage values. Then yes, that is also possible. If you want the percentage values, how do I do that? Or how I can convert these numbers into the percentage values? If you can observe, the moment I just drag and drop that sales into the label pill, this particular label pill has been created into the marks card, sum of sales, and this T is there. That means it's a label pill. If I want to convert that particular number into a percentage value, then I have to go to the sum of sales label pill. Just click over here and you have an option called quick table calculation. And inside that quick table calculation, you have an option called percent of total. Let me repeat that point. If you want to convert those numbers into the percentage values, you have a sum of sales label pill, right? Go to that sum of sales label pill, go to that quick table calculation, and inside that quick table calculation, you have an option called percentage of total. You can click on to this percentage of total, and all the respective numbers have been converted into percentage. All right. Now someone can ask me or someone can tell me, I don't like these decimal numbers. I want to convert these decimal numbers into the whole number. Then how do I do that? It is also very easy in Tableau. Okay. It's the user interface and the vocabulary is very easy. Again, I have to go to this sum of sales label pill. Okay. And I have to click on to this format. The moment I click on to this format, this particular window will be opening. Let me go to this number section. In the number section, I have an option called percentage and make it as zero. All right. Let me repeat that point. Don't get confused. Click over here. Click on format. This window will be opening. Click over here in the number section. Go to the percentage section and make it as zero decimal places as zero. Now close this window. You have decimal values, you have percentage values, but now you don't have decimals. All right. Now a beautiful pie chart has been created. Now what is our final destination? As I told you at the initial only, that your source data should be clear. You should be very much familiar with your source data. That is first thing. And the second thing is that what you need to do, what you need to create, that should be clear. Finally, we will be creating a dashboard. By today itself, we will be creating a dashboard. Okay, so we are preparing ourselves to create a final dashboard, and we'll see how the dashboard is interacting with each other to get the insight of the data, to get the data analysis. Okay, so we have a particular chart. Let me just rename this chart as a pie chart. All right, and this is the sales. Now let me create one more sheet so that I can pull that sheet into my dashboard. Just let me take this category into the column shelf and let me take this sales into the row shelf. All right. And I have a bar chart has been created. Let me take that sales and put it into label itself so that I will be having label for the category wise, for furniture, for office supplies, and for technology. All right. And let me format this and let me just increase the font size. All right. To format this particular chart, what I did is I just right click over here and click on format. All right. Now let me take this category into colors. All right. And just let me edit this color. So go to this color box and click on edit. And here in the furniture, let me take a blue color. All right. So this is the sheet 3 and let me rename this sheet. To rename the sheet, what we need to do is the way we do in Excel sheet, right click over here and click on rename. So this is category, only category, not subcategory. All right, this is pie chart, this is category, and this is sales, but for the categories and subcategories. Now my final destination is to create a dashboard. How do I create a dashboard and how I can analyze my data into more deeper? Now let me create a dashboard. To create a dashboard, what you need to do, you just need to click onto this particular new dashboard window button. Can you see that button? This is the button where you have to click to create a dashboard, right? So let me click onto this dashboard, and this is the first user interface to create a dashboard. This is the first user interface of the dashboard where you will be working. This is a clean dashboard. This is the sheet on which you have to create a dashboard. But let me give you the definition of the dashboard. First of all, what is the definition of a dashboard? A definition of a dashboard is nothing but a collection of sheets. Okay, a definition of a dashboard is nothing but a collection of sheets. Collection of sheets. So I have prepared multiple sheets. Now what I can do is I can just drag and drop those sheets into my dashboard, and I can do my data analysis very easily. All right. Now let me just pull my sheets into my dashboard. But before pulling the sheet, what I'll do before pulling the sheet, let me resize this dashboard. All right. So to resize the dashboard, what I need to do is I can just click onto this fixed size, and let me just select this generic desktop. All right. What I did is I just clicked onto this particular fixed size, and just let me click onto this generic desktop. So in that way, I will be having maximum size to create my dashboard, right? So I have just resized my dashboard. Now just let me pull my sheets. I have sales with me, or I have category with me. Okay, this is the category. What I did is I just drag and drop category sheet into my dashboard. Now I want to analyze my data, or I want to analyze my sales as far as my subcategories are concerned. Let me take this subcategory. See, it is asking me where to put it. It is asking me where to put it. Okay, so here I want to put it. All right, this is for the category. This is for the subcategory. All right. Now what I need to do is I can take this pie chart. I can also take this pie chart and I can pull over here, so that I can have my data related to pie chart also. Okay, three of the sheets I have just pulled it into my dashboard. Now let me remove the unnecessary elements. Okay, the element which I don't want, let me remove those unnecessary element. And I can resize my sheets like this way, so that I can see my data individually. All right. Now I wanted to do an analysis onto my data, how it is working. So if I click onto this particular furniture, nothing is happening. If I click onto this particular office supplies, nothing is happening. If I click onto this particular technology, nothing is happening. All right. So these are not talking to each others. Okay, these are not talking to each others. They are not friends right now. We have to make them friends. All right. So to make them friends, what we can do? I have created a dashboard. I have pulled three sheets, but they are not talking to each other. They have a problem between each others, right? So I have to make them interactive. How I make them interactive? So what I can do is I can make for making them interactive. What I can do is I can just click onto this filter button. This is the easiest method. There are multiple ways you can interact your between. You can make sheets interactive. So what you can do is you can just click onto this filter button. Okay, you can go over here and you can click onto this filter button, and you can just go to this particular sheet and what you can do is you can just click onto this filter button. All right, now they are interacting with each other. Let us try that, whether they are talking to each other or not. Just if I click onto this furniture one, see, I'll only be able to see the data related to furniture only, number wise as well as the percentage wise. Now what is the maximum percentage which has been sold for this furniture? 37% of furniture has been sold for the chairs only, and you can see from the numbers as well, 15 lakh and 1682 sales has been done for this particular chair as far as my furniture category is concerned. All right, as far as this office supply is concerned, if I click onto this office supplies, you can see all the subcategories related to office supplies. All right, and you can see this pie chart also, which is giving you data related to percentage wise. If I click onto this particular technology, you can see data related to technology and the maximum sales which has been done for phones, because everybody is using cell phones. 36% of sales has been done for cell phone, and here on the number itself you can see 17 lakh rupees of sales have been done for the phone itself. All right, now let me show you one more thing. If you want to make this particular dashboard even more interactive, then what you can do, if you want to make this particular dashboard more interactive, what you can do, you can just go to this format and click on to this animations. Go to this format and click on to this animations. All right, and you can on the animation, and let me make it as 1 second. All right, so what I did is I just went to this particular format option, format tab, and I just clicked onto this animation. This particular window has come up, this window has come up, and I just need to click onto this on button, and duration will be 1 second. All right, now if I click onto any other category, see what will happen. Some animation is working onto this particular chart. All right, so in that way you can create your particular dashboard, and you can present that particular dashboard to the management people, and they can analyze their data in much more better manner. All right, so that they can improve their businesses. All right, now what else we can do with this particular dashboard? Okay, there are plenty of options to be explored as far as this particular dashboard is concerned. Let's suppose you are making this particular dashboard for a laptop user or for a PC user, that is okay. But what if you are making this particular dashboard for a person who wants to see that data into their mobile phones, into their iPhone, then what we can do? If they want to see, or if you want to create your data for the cell phones, for the iPhone only, then what is the option we have with us? Okay, so what is the option we have? We have an option called device preview. In that device preview, if you click onto that device preview, it will give you a preview that how this particular dashboard will be looking into the iPhone itself. Okay, someone has asked me that how we can create that dashboard. You don't have to do anything, you just have to drag and drop. You just have to drag and drop your sheets, okay, into this particular dashboard, and that dashboard will be created. What is the definition of that particular dashboard? The dashboard will be created. Just you have to pull your sheets into the work area, right? So if I want to see this device preview option, what I need to do is, first of all, in the size itself, I have to make it as automatic. Okay, I have to make it as automatic in the size itself, and then later on let me click on to this device preview. Okay, if I click on to this particular device preview, and in the device itself, let me check this option called phone. Okay, let me check this option called phone, and in the phone itself, let me check this option called iPhone 7. All right. Now, if I want to see this particular view, okay, in the iPhone itself. okay, in the iPhone itself. So this will be the particular view. All right. Now, if I want to edit that particular view, let me click on to this particular button. All right. Or let me click on to this default one or custom one. All right. So this is the visibility in my iPhone. Now, if I want to change the visibility as a tablet, let me click on to this tablet. Okay, in which tablet I wanted to see? I wanted to see Google Nexus. So here I can check this Google Nexus. So if I want a portrait view or a landscape view, to see that portrait view and landscape view, I can click over in this particular button and I can see this particular visibility in the portrait mode and in the landscape view. All right. And if I want to save this view, then there is an option called add tablet layout. So let me click on to this add tablet layout. Okay, and this will be added as a tablet. All right. So this is how you will be creating your dashboard for a particular business user as far as your cell phone is concerned and as far as your tablet is concerned. All right. And let me press just F7. F7 is to present your data visualization into the presentation mode. So let me press the F7 mode, just F7 button. And this is the final data visualization which I have as far as this dashboard is concerned. And see, it is giving me a beautiful view. Now you can send this particular view to your management people as well. All right. Yes, we can remove that line also, Gajendra. All right. Now let me show you one more thing, but before showing that filter option, I can filter out my data as well. All right. So how I can filter my data in the Tableau itself? I can filter my data very easily. I'll show you that option, but before showing you that particular option, let me just give you a brief overview, or let me show you one more thing over here. Okay, so if you want to see or if you want to get the particular recording for the today's session, I'm just pasting that particular link into the comment section. Okay, if you go to over here, you can see that. Okay, here you have to click over here and then you will be redirected to our Facebook page. All right. Or if you want to see the data onto the YouTube itself or today's recording. Okay, this is for you to see the recording for today's session onto Facebook or YouTube. So you have to just click onto this YouTube button or Facebook button, and there you will be redirected to the social media platform, that is Facebook and YouTube. And there you will be able to see the recording. Okay. And if you are seeing our recording onto the Facebook page, then kindly like and follow our Facebook page for the upcoming recording. All right. And this is just for your information, because a lot of people have been asking about this particular thing. So we are also running a full-time program. All right. We are also running a full-time program for this particular Tableau. All right. So this is the course content. Okay. We have 20 different modules available as far as the complete Tableau course is concerned. The thing which I have showed you, this is only the 5% of Tableau, but still we have 20 different modules available as far as this Tableau complete course is concerned. Okay. This is your complete course. This is filter. These are the different 20 modules which are we will be covering into the full-time course. This is the calculated field. Okay, this is the table calculation, time and series, advanced dashboard, your RDBMS concept, that is joining the data, blending the data, table calculation, advanced data preparation. Okay, clusters, groups and sets. These are the really important topics or the advanced topics, the level of detail calculation. Okay, creating the animations, how you can create. This is one of the fascinating topic as far as Tableau is concerned, creating the animations. Okay, and finally we'll be taking a conclusion and the bonus section, that is interview Q&A, that is interview question and answer. So if you're preparing for an interview, then also we have a top 30 or top 50 questions as far as the interviews are concerned. So we'll be running a full-time course also. So if you're interested, you can enroll yourself for this complete 20 module full-time course on Tableau. Okay, the new batches is going to start from the 29th of August. Okay. And the charges for this particular is 2350 only. Alright. So in case if you are interested for the full time 20 module course on Tableau, you can enroll yourself in just 2350. Alright. As far as this Tableau is concerned, this is very much high in demand technology nowadays. And this is the right time to upscale yourself, because nowadays it is not a additional skills, it is a mandatory skills, because everybody has to create a data visualization and they have to just prepare their data visualization and show to their management people so that business can take their decisions, right? This is not the only thing which you can create. There are plenty of features and options available in the Tableau itself, where you can explore and you can create multiple dashboards. This is just the basic of Tableau which we have covered up today, 5% of Tableau only, right? So I was talking about the next option, that is filters option, right? How I can play with the filters. Let me go to this particular sales. All right. Now, if I want to filter out my data, okay, if I want to filter out my data, then how do I do that? To filter out my data, I don't have to do anything. I just have to drag and drop this subcategory pill and I have to put it into filter shelf. This particular window will be coming up. If I want to filter out my data, I just need to uncheck over here. And if I click apply, see that data has gone now. Alright. And if I want to check everything, I just need to check this all button. And just let me click on apply and let me click on OK. Alright. So in that way, what will happen is that all the data will be filtered out. And if I want to see a quick filter, let me click over here and click on to the show filter option. If I want to see that show filter option, let me click on to the show filter and I will be having this particular subcategory. All right. So how I can just check and uncheck? Just let me uncheck this option and see this, my data will be filtered out like anything. So this is the easiest method if I want to filter out my data. Alright, if I want to see the top 10 values or the top 20 values or top 5 values, how do I do that? Just let me click over here and click on edit filter. Here we have an option called top tab. Alright, let me click on to this top tab and let me click on to this by field option, and I have an option called top tab. Right, in that way I can see my top 5 values. So let me just click over this and give a top 5. Click on apply and click on OK. I can see only the top 5 values related to sales. If I wanted to see the bottom 5 values, then let me click over here and click on again edit filter. I have a top tab. Let me click on to this bottom and I wanted to see the bottom 5 values. Bottom 5 values on the sum of sales. Bottom 5 values on the sum of sales. Let me click on apply and let me click on OK. These are the bottom 5 sum of sales. Alright, let me repeat that point. Just you need to go to this particular filter and click on edit filter and see this top tab at the end. So in that way, from this particular drop down list, you can see your top 5 values and bottom 5 values, right? So in that way, your data will be sorted or filtered out the way you want. Still, there are plenty of options to be explored. But in this particular 1 hour of session, that is how we can play with our data. All right. So if you have any kind of doubt or any kind of query, you can ask into the chat section. I'll be happy to answer. Okay. So there are a couple of questions. Let me answer this question. I have give. First of all, what you need to do is just keep that link handy. Okay, in this particular link, you will be getting all the recording. Okay, and there you can go to the Facebook and YouTube to see the recording. All right, that is first thing. And if you are interested for the full-time course enrollment, if you want to learn Tableau for the all the 20 modules, and if you want to upskill yourself in this lockdown period, then there is a number given over here in this page itself. You can contact to this number. This is the number for our representative. You can kindly call to him and you can talk to him. Still there are batches going on for the Tableau session, right? Now there is one question asked from the Gajendra. What about certification? Yes, a course completion certificate has been given by us once you finish the course. This is only a week, this is only 24 hours of course. In the 24 hours we will be covering all the things. As far as tomorrow's session link is concerned, the link will be same. With the same link you will be able to connect for the tomorrow session as well. So this is just the information to all of you that we have a session for tomorrow as well, right? So if you connect with us for the tomorrow session, we can connect tomorrow also at the same time, that is 12 o'clock, and I will be explaining you some different topics of Tableau for tomorrow session. Okay, so we'll be connecting tomorrow as well with the same link. Yeah, Manoj, as far as the self-paced is concerned, you can talk to our representative. The number is given onto the webpage itself, the link which I have pasted. This is the answer to the Manoj's question. Okay, I have pasted the link. You can kindly talk to our representative. Yeah, I'll be pasting, or we'll mail you. This is the answer to the question on the Shailendra. We will mail you the link how you can download the Tableau software. All right. How we can export the dashboard? You can export the dashboard. If you can save your dashboard onto the cloud itself, that is one more option. Okay, and you can export also your dashboard to the different applications like MS Office, PPTs, and all. This is also one of the option available. Yes, we can share this particular dashboard who do not have Tableau installed. We can share your work as a Tableau workbook. In that way, you have to save your Tableau workbook, and then you can save that particular workbook to the people who doesn't have Tableau with them. But if you are sharing the Tableau workbook, then definitely they should have the software. No, Shriyama, 24 hour, not in 3 weeks. It's a okay, we also having weekday batches, and we are also having weekend batches. So we will be completing the complete entire module in 1 month. Okay, we also having weekly batches, so weekly batches will be completing before 1 month only. And if it is if you can connect, or if you want to connect at the weekend batches, then it will take at least 1 month. We'll be connecting on Saturdays and Sundays, and then we'll be completing the session. There are a couple of questions which has been asked. The topic for the next session, that we will be doing one more case studies. Okay, the topic for tomorrow session will not be same. Today I have just given you a basic overview. Tomorrow also we will be having a session, and the topic will be different. We will be doing a case study for tomorrow. All right, this is the answer to the Avanti's question. Yeah, there is one more question which has been asked from the Pavan itself, that what is the complete duration? The complete duration is 24 hours only. And if you want more information onto that, I have pasted the link itself. In the link itself, the number has been given to our representative. You can call to him and you can discuss with him. Okay, for all the queries, will be answered. Yes, Tableau is a free version. You can download Tableau Public and you can practice. Tableau software free version that is available onto the internet. Okay, this has been the question which has been asked from so many people, that what is the difference between the Power BI and Tableau. Okay, so as far as the difference between the Power BI and Tableau is concerned, there is a difference that Power BI is a Microsoft product. It's also a data visualization feature, but whatever charts which you can prepare, like your box and whisker plot and all, so whatever charts which you can prepare in Tableau, that particular charts are not available in Power BI, and those charts which are available in Power BI, those charts cannot be prepared into Tableau. So both the tools have their pros and cons. Okay, some of the features and functionalities which are available in Tableau, those features and functionalities are not available in Power BI. Okay, and some of the features and functionality which is available in Power BI, those features and options are not available in Tableau. But both are data visualization tool. But nowadays, Tableau is more in demand. That is why companies are looking for the resources who are skilled in Tableau. Okay, and I hope, and I personally think that this is the right time to skill yourself as far as the Tableau is concerned, because this is not an additional skill, this is a mandatory skill nowadays, because everybody wants to see the data visualization, right? Yes, if you want to connect for the tomorrow session, the link will be same, but still if you are finding any difficulties, I have just pasted the link into the chat section. You just kindly go to that particular web page and there you can see a number, our representative number. If you have any doubt, if you have any query, you can call to that number. Our representative will be answering all of your queries. Yeah, you can connect. This is the question has been asked by the Ashish, that you can connect to the Oracle and you can use SQL. Alright, you can use SQL and you can play with your data. Okay, let me paste the number itself. People are asking for the number. So yes, we do have a number. This is the contact number for our representative. Alright, I have pasted the number of our representative. His name is Kumar. If you are finding any difficulties for the tomorrow session as well, you can kindly contact him and you can sort your issues if you are finding any difficulties for tomorrow session. Alright, and if you want to enroll for the full-time course, the batches are going to start from the 29th of August. Then also you can call him and you can ask him whatever query you have. Yes, definitely. See, you can just explore. This is the question asked by the Arpit Sarkar. Oh, by the way, first of all, nice name. Okay, so free version of Tableau. If you're working onto the free version of Tableau, definitely you will be able to work onto the any practical kind of project and you'll be able to do certifications, because all the features are available into that free version. There are very few features which are not available into the free version, but 95% of the features you can explore, alright, and all your work that can be possible into the Tableau public itself. I have given the contact number. If you have any doubt, any query, kindly call to that particular number related to the full-time courses and related to the tomorrow session as well. We do have a session for tomorrow also, and tomorrow will be a different topic to be covered up. We'll be doing a case study tomorrow. Alright, couple of questions, let me answer them. Yes, that data will be filtered, that will be dynamic. If you change anything in your source data, that will be reflected automatically. Alright. Yes, this is the question from the Arun B. Yes, you can export your work into the Excel sheet or into the PPT or into the Word file, and from there also you can share your work. But if the other person has Tableau installed into their software, then you can share your file, that is your Tableau workbook. So in that way he'll be able to see your work. This is the answer to the Arun's question. Yes, that data is dynamic, definitely. No, this is the beauty. This has been a very nice question which has been asked by the Sri Rama, that you don't need any background coding knowledge to work on Tableau. This is the beauty of Tableau, that even a technical person can learn Tableau and even a non-technical people can also learn Tableau. Okay, it is not restricted to any kind of coding. If you are zero in technical knowledge, then also you can learn Tableau. All right. So there is no coding background needed as far as Tableau is concerned. Yes, we will be sharing the whole recording onto the YouTube as well as onto the Facebook itself. You can see the today's recording onto YouTube as well as on the Facebook as well, but it will take time, at least 4 to 5 hours to upload the recording. All right, so bear with us for the next 4 to 5 hours. Okay, as far as there is a nice question asked by the Anchal, that what is the career option? As far as Tableau is concerned, it is the latest technology. It's a hot cake. Okay, Power BI and Tableau both have a very nice future. Both have a very bright future. And as far as Tableau is concerned, it has a very nice career options. Okay, every company wants a person who can create data visualization. The data visualization, the recording, the chart which we have prepared, it's a very basic chart. Okay. The client want your dashboard like anything. You have to create the data visualization like anything. There is an ocean in Tableau if you start learning, right? And there are a couple of features and functionality which needs to be covered up. That is why we are running a full-time course, that is 20 module course, in that advanced topics are also covered. So if you want to create your career in Tableau, it has a very nice future. No coding background is needed, as I told you. There is a question asked by the Hardeep that how we can export our chart. Okay, I'll tell you, in Tableau public, just for the Tableau public, that option is not available. But as far as this Tableau desktop is concerned, to exporting your chart, that option is available into the Tableau desktop. As far as MicroStrategy is concerned, I don't think that has much features and functionality. But as far as Tableau is concerned, it's like anything. It is a hot cake, and they are upgrading the Tableau day by day, so that you will be having maximum drag and drop options and maximum features and functionality to create your data visualization. All right. No, Bhupendra, we don't need to know any other language to work on Tableau. Even with a person who has done a BCom, who doesn't have any technical knowledge, they can also learn Tableau. This is the beauty of Tableau only. You don't need any prior knowledge. Yeah, but the basic concept which we will be covering into the advanced topic, if you want to learn Tableau, the basic functions, features and functionality which are technical, definitely we will be covering up into the course itself. But if you do not know anything, then definitely you can start learning onto it. No, Hardeep, that data will not be dynamic. You will be posting that data into the PPT itself. So that will not be dynamic. But if the people have Tableau installed, then definitely you can share your work as a Tableau workbook. No, if you have the SQL knowledge, that will be a plus. That the question has been asked from the Mithun. If you have the SQL knowledge, prior knowledge, that is well and good. But if you do not have the knowledge, then also you can start working. Then also you can start your career in Tableau. The basic part of SQL, the basic part of the RDBMS concept, that will be covered up into the course itself. So the person who doesn't have any knowledge of SQL, they can start learning, they can start their career into Tableau. Okay. Yes, definitely. If they want to see the Tableau dashboard or Tableau workbook flawlessly with this all the features and animation, definitely Tableau server and Tableau online should be installed onto that particular PC. But if you just want to give them a overview as a picture, as an image, then you can export your work into PPT or into Excel file or into Word file, and then you can share your work as a picture. But if that other person have installed the Tableau, yes, you can work, he can see your complete animated work. there are a lot of kalpana, there are a lot of ways to share your work as a, okay, you can save your work as a workbook, or else you can save your work as an image and then you can share your work. As far as there is a question asked from the Navin, what is the compared to Power BI? As far as Power BI is concerned, I personally feel that Tableau has more features and functionality. That is why the reason that each and every company is running behind the Tableau, okay, because it has a variety of charts and variety of data visualization option is available. For tomorrow's session, we won't be covering the SQL scripting. For tomorrow's session, we will be doing a case study. Yes, there is a very much good opportunity for fresher as well. This is the answer to the Nikhil's question. This is the BI technology. This is the data visualization business intelligence technology. And you can see each and every business people want the data visualization only. No matter how an engineer works very much hard to prepare your data, but finally the credit goes to the people who prepares your data visualization. Don't you think that the end people who prepare the data visualization, who create the dashboard, they will take all the advantages? Splunk is a altogether a different story as far as the Tableau is concerned. Splunk is to get the logs. Okay, so Splunk is a altogether different story. Yes, we will be giving you a certification also after the course completion. Okay, we have one more question. Yes, if you want to refresh your dashboard, there are options available into the Tableau itself. If you change the data, let's suppose today you have a sales for 1 lakh rupees, and if you change the data source, okay, that will be reflected automatically into the dashboard. There are options available. This is the question to the Murugasan. Yes, Kalpana, you can see the real-time data also in Tableau. You do a changes into your Excel file, into your source data, and that will be reflected in your data visualization. Yes, we have a recording for this video, but it will take time at least 4 to 5 hours to upload that video. SAPBio is also a data reporting or the reporting tool, but SAPBio has a very limited options. Tableau is a data visualization tool which has a lot of variety of features and functionality. SAPBio has a very limited features. This is the answer to the Shri Rama's question. Okay, I hope that today's information or today's session will be informative to all of you. I hope you have enjoyed today's session also, the way we have just created a beautiful dashboard, and the way we have seen this, how we can just explore our data or how we can create our dashboard for the different functionalities. If you are interested for the full-time course also, you can contact to that particular number and all the queries will be answered. This is the number for our representative. Tomorrow also we have a session, and tomorrow we will be covering a different topic. All right. Okay, so till then, in this COVID-19 pandemic situation, be safe, stay at home, take care of yourself, take care of your family members. This is Pawan signing off. Thank you so much, guys, for attending today's session. Until then, happy learning. चाय लिया मैंने यार, बहुत सवाल पूछते हैं यार ये लोग।
आप क्या आईटी ट्रेनर हैं क्या?
एक मिनट रिकॉर्डिंग बंद कर दूं।